Good afternoon, students. Today I will explain you about the ARM instruction set. In that ARM instruction set, multiply instruction. So this will comes under the data processing instruction. So multiply instruction, this is the syntax for the multiply instruction. MLA, condition, so this is the condition, and S bit. This is SB, when S is there means it will update the flags in CPSR register. And this is multiply and accumulate. The MLA is nothing but multiply and accumulate. So you have two source registers. So it will add RS, it will multiply RS and RN and added with RM. And whatever the result you are getting, that will be stored in RD. So this is the multiply and accumulate. So that means it will multiply the content of two registers and added with one more register, and the result will be stored in RD, destination register. And this is multiply, so multiply condition, and this is S, it will update, if S is there means it will update the flags in CPSR. So it will multiply RM and RS, result will be stored in RD. So this is the operation, MLA is nothing but multiply and accumulate. So RM into RS, plus RN, so result will be stored in RD. Multiply means RM into RS, so result will be stored in RD. So multiply and accumulate means it will multiply and add with one more content of the register. And multiply means simply it will multiply the content of two registers, the result will be stored in destination register. And these are for unsigned long multiplication and signed long multiplication. So if you are multiplying two 32-bit numbers, result you can get for long multiplication, you can get the 64-bit value. So this is the syntax, instruction, condition, and S bit. Suppose if you are multiplying two 32-bit numbers, either unsigned, signed multiplication or unsigned multiplication, you are getting 32-bit value. So lower 32-bit value will be stored in RD low. And higher 32-bit value will be stored in RD high. So here these are the instructions. SMLAL. So S is nothing but signed. MLA is nothing but multiply and accumulate. L means long. So what it will do the signed multiply and accumulate long. So that means it will multiply RM into RS. And it will be added with RD high and RD low. So whatever the result you are getting, lower 32-bit will be saved in RD low, and higher 32-bit will be saved in RD high. So this is nothing but signed multiply and accumulate long. And here this is a signed multiply long. So this is simply multiply. So signed multiply long. So it will multiply RM into RS. So whatever the 64-bit result you are getting, so that will be stored in this registers. So lower 32-bit value will be stored in RD low, and higher 32-bit value will be stored in RD high. And this is unsigned multiply and accumulate. So unsigned, U is for unsigned, MLA is nothing but multiply and accumulate, and L means long. So it will multiply RM and RS. So this will be added with RDHI and RDH low, and whatever the result, 64-bit result you are getting, so lower 32-bit value will be stored in RD low, and higher 32-bit value will be stored in RD high. So same thing, this is unsigned multiply long. So it will multiply to content of two registers, RM and RS. So whatever the result you are getting, 64-bit value. So lower 32-bit value will be stored in RD low, and higher 32-bit value will be stored in RD high. So these are the format for the unsigned multiplication and signed multiplication. So coming to one operation. So suppose if you consider R0 is all zeros, or R1 is all zeros, and R2 is how much? 0xf followed by 6 zeros and 2. And R3 is nothing but 0x followed by 7 zeros and 2. So you want to do this unsigned multiplication. So unsigned multiplication long. So you are multiplying the content of R2 and R3, and result will be stored in. So result is what? It's a result is the 64-bit value. This is unsigned multiply long, no? So a lower 32-bit value will be stored in R0 and higher 32-bit value will be stored in R1. Suppose here, if you consider, that means here 2 into 2 means 4. So 4 will be stored in R0. And F means 15. 15 into 2, so that is 30. So 30 if you convert into hexadecimal. So see here, if you convert into hexadecimal, that is 1E. Okay. So E will come over here and 1 will be come over here. So that means 15, 2 sorry, is 30. So if you convert 30 into hexadecimal, that value is 1E. So E will be stored in RD low. So RD low means R0. And 1 will be stored in RD high. So that is RD high, that is R1. So this is a program to evaluate this expression. So this is nothing but XI, YI. So this is nothing but we can call this as multiply and addition. So multiplying the content of two values. So suppose you are taking equal to 0, x0, y0 plus x1, y1, x2, y2 up to so on, xn minus 1 and yn minus 1. So that means you are multiplying the content of two registers, and next you are adding and you are storing in the value in the z. One register. So this is the starting of the program area. So this is assembler directive. So one should be there say that where you are writing the program. So this is the name of the file program, and you are writing in code read only. So read only means it's a program memory, and entry is nothing but starting of the program. So here you have to initialize the two variables x and y. So define constant double. So you are initializing how many values? 5 values. So these x have 5 values and y has 5 values. So that means each value is how much? 32 bit. So each value is 32 bit. So that means what you are doing? You are multiplying. That means 1 into 1 means 1. Next you are doing 2 into 2. So 2 into 2 means 4. So previously you got the value as 1, no? So 4 plus 1 you are adding and you are storing in one of the register. So next you are doing 3 into 3. So 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 9 you are getting. So that value again you are storing in one of the register. So like that you are doing multiplying two numbers. Again you are adding to the previous value. So first you have to initialize the count. So how many numbers are there? Here 5 numbers are there. So here you have to initialize the count n equal to 5. So that means you are initializing the count to what? R0. And next LDR, so load the register. So there should be some address for the x, no? So that x you are loading into R1, and load register. So there should be load register. This is the loading. This is nothing but these are the instructions comes under the loading the constants. So there will be some address for y. So whatever that address is there, you are storing in R2, and you are initializing R5 with 0. These are the initial values. So result should be get into R5 and R6. So R5 and R6. So whatever the R5 and R6 are there. So you are initializing to 0. And what you are doing LDR, R3 and R1 as 4. So that means the content of the address location which is pointed by R1, you are moving into R3. So what is the content? 1 is there. So 1 is the content of R1. You are moving into R3. After moving this into R3, you are incrementing the address with 4. So this we call as a post increment. So after moving the value present in R1 to R3, so that means address pointed by R1. So what is the, that is X value. So what is the first value? 1, you are moving into R3. After moving into R3, you are incrementing the address location by 4. Similarly, you have to take the value of y. So the address of y is stored in where? R2. So this bracket says that, so there is a value present in R location which is pointed by R2, you are moving into R4. So that means one is there, no? So one you are moving into R4. After moving into R4, you are incrementing the address location by 4. Why you are incrementing means, so this is a 32-bit value. So that means in each location you can accommodate 8-bit value. So that means 1 byte. So 32-bit value, if you convert into bytes, so you'll get 4 bytes. So that's why for every transfer of data, I have to increment the memory location by 4. So here what you are doing, unsigned multiply and accumulate L, long. So multiply and accumulate long. So that means you are multiplying R3 and R4. So R3 into R4. So what is R3? Here 1 into 1. So 1 into 1 means you are getting 1 plus R5 and R6. R6 and R5 you are adding. So what are the content of R5 and R6? These are 0 only. So 0 plus. So what you are getting to the result? Result is 1. So 1 you are saving in R5 and R6. Okay. So that means you are multiplying two numbers. And whatever the previous values are there. So here you initialize the previous values are 0 only. No? So 0 plus 1. So that will be saved in R5 and R6. So one multiplication is completed. So when you complete one multiplication, you have to decrement the count by 1. No? So this is the count. N equal to how 5 numbers are there. So sub s. So sub s means s means it will update the flag registers. So sub s r naught comma 1. So that means r naught becomes 4. Now branch not equal. So that means it will check for the 0 flag. So branch is it is not equal to 0. It will be going to the next. So next you take the next value. So 2 into 2. So 2 so 2 value are taking into R3 and 2 value are taking into R4. And next you are multiplying and accumulate. So 2 into 2 means 4. So what is the previous value? 1. 1 plus 4. You are getting 5. So that 5 will be saved in R5 and R6. And next it will be decremented. It becomes 3. Branch if not equal. So there is a 0 flag. That means branch if not equal means it is checking for the count means so 0 flag. So 0 flag, it is not equal to 0. It will go into the this next. Again, you are taking these three value into R3 and three value into R4. And next what you are doing, you are multiplying and accumulate. So here 3 into 3 means 9. 9 plus, what is the previous value? 5. 9 plus 5 is how much? So 9 plus 5 is 14. So it will be converted into. So like that it will be repeated till the count becomes 0. So till the count becomes 0, it will be repeated. Okay. So, and after completing this this branch instruction, so after making this R0, so when R0 becomes 0, so this condition is not satisfying, branch not equal. So that means the zero flag is affected. So branch if not equal, so it will come to the next instruction. So you are terminating the program. So that means it will be the same. So this program I will show you in the Keen software. So see this one. So same program. So same program whatever I explained, this program I written in this Keel software. See here. So first you have to get the values. Okay. So so in the debug session, R naught equal to what? R naught you got as 5. Okay. So observe here, R naught you got as 5. And next step by step, if you see, you should get the address of X. So what is the address of X? 0x2c. So see here, this is the address of X. 0x2c will be the address of X. And what is the address of R2? R2 will be 0x40. So 0x40 is the address of R2. So you have to use two memories. So what is address of X? And next one is address of Y. So address of X is 0x2c. and address of y is 0x4 0s. Okay, so 0x 6 0s followed by 4 0. So you have to give that address. So 0x. So you got the address of this one. So 0x4 0 means you will get the address of y. So memory 1 is the address of x and memory 2 is the address of y. Okay. So next. Next step by step, so you are initializing R5 to 0 and R6 to 0. So those are the initial values of R5 and R6. Okay. So next, what you should do? So first value you should move into R3. After that, you have to increment the address by what? 4. Okay. Post increment. So you got the value R1 as what? 1. So now address of the R1 becomes 30. So that means initially that is a 2C, so that becomes 130. Okay, so if you see observe here, so that's where that value come into the this location. And next get the value of R4. So that R4, this value is 1. You are moving into 1. Next, what you should do, you have to multiply and accumulate. You have to multiply two numbers. Okay, so that means 1 into 1, so 1. So that will come into R5 and R6. So yeah, this instruction will be executed. So that will be come into R5 and R6. So next step, the count becomes what? 4. So you multiply two numbers, no? So count becomes 4. So if it is not equal to 0, go to the again next. Again get the next values. So what are those next values? 2 into 2, no? So 2 you are bringing into R3. And next 2 you are bringing into R4. So you are bringing into R3. Next, what you are doing? You are multiplying. Okay. So means when you are bringing into R3 and R4, you have to increment the address location, no? By 4. So it will be 4 into 4 plus 1. So the result is 5, no? R5, 5 will be saved. And R6, 0 will be saved. So that means the result will be stored in R6 and R5. Okay, next step, count becomes 3. So count is not equal to 0. Next, again, so whatever the three values are there, three values that will come into R3 and R4, and it will multiply. So R4 is 3 and R3 is 3, and it will be multiplied. So it will be multiplied. So that means previous value is there, no? 5 plus 9 is how much? E, 0E. So 0E will be saved in R5. R6 you have 0x00 only. So next count becomes what? 2. So three numbers you multiplied, no? Now you are taking the values of 4 into which R3 and R4. You are taking the value and you are multiplying. So you are getting the result as 1. And next count becomes 1. Next it is not equal to 0. It will go to the there on 5 into 5 is, so you are getting the result at 37. So 37 you are getting into which register? R5 and R6. So you're getting the values in R5 and 37 is the result. So you are multiplying these 5 numbers. So when you are multiplying, you are getting 37. 37 is a lower order 32 bit that is coming into R5, and R6 you are getting higher order 32 bit. Okay, so this is how you have to make you have to write the program okay. So you have to write the program to multiply two numbers. Okay, thank you.